Spellmaker, Spellmaker, make me a spell. Was it create shield? How high will it go? It'll go up to 99. Haha. Really? Okay. So creates a shield that starts off at 1 hit point and increases 99 more hit points per every 1 level. This is, I mean, I can do it. This could be breaking the game at this point. But this is how mages rule, because I don't know. So I'm starting off at the default shield spell, I think, is 35 points. So I'm starting off at 100 points for just level 1, and then increasing 99 for every 1 level. So whatever 99 times 9 is, which is, hold on. is 891. So it's 900. So for me, it's 991 point shield. Spell cost, though. So, wait. I'm not sure if I can cast this. If I go exit, right? Casting cost is 199. I cannot cast this. So that's for the future. What's it say? 199? So if I get my intelligence maxed, what you can do is cast that shield on yourself, which is going to go up higher every time you gain a level. Basically limitless, unless there's a level cap in this game. I don't think there is. I don't think there is any level cap. So it's basically, if I'm right, it's basically unlimited. But as soon as you max out your intelligence, you can cast that. And it should go down lower. And then what you do... It should go down lower as you level up anyway. But then what you do is you sleep, you cast a shield on yourself, which is going to drain all your mana, then you sleep, get your mana up to full, and the shield is still there because nothing, it just lasts until, you know, enemies chip away at the shield. So, you're really powerful at that point. Alright, so I just want to see. I can't cast it yet because I have 154 spell points. So I maybe have to go down to 50 points per level for right now. I'll try that. How much again? 154. Remember that. Create shield. Fifty. Casting cost is 101. So I can go higher than that. Maybe 75? Can I type in this box? See if I, no. $151. Okay, so it's one hit point shield plus 75 points every one level. So whatever 75 times 9, I basically have about, yeah. No, I, yeah. 675 plus 1 for the first level. So 676 points shield. Spell cost is 3020. Which I have 5000 something. So what are we going to call this then? Let me see. These Aedra, aka gods and goddesses, are not created yet for in arena. I wonder what would make sense in context. How about spacebar has been remapped to J. I can't make this. Hold on a second. There we go. Kynareth's shield. Caster only effects. Save versus none. This is my info. Casting cost is 151, which would be almost all my mana. Buy spell. The spell has been inscribed in your spellbook, Kynareth's shield. Exit. So. Kynareth's shield. Okay, my custom spell. Now I know in Daggerfall you can make them. I think even Morrowind, and I'm not sure about Oblivion, but I know Skyrim you can't create your own spells. Can't say Oblivion. I don't remember. I haven't played Oblivion. I know in Morrowind you can as well. I haven't played much of Morrowind either. Alright, so I have 26, 27 left. Is there anything else I would like to create? I think, what I don't have... This is just gonna be, well, a spellbook. Resist fire, cold, shock. Cure poison. I don't have a cure... disease spell. And I would like to have one. I think... I think for whatever reason you can't buy the spells. Maybe you can find them in dungeons. Because at least it's not here. But I can create it. Cure poison. What does Shalador's mirror do? 40% chance to reflect a spell back at opposing caster. Okay, duration is one round per one level. So you could ramp that right up and make it 99 rounds per level. And then just delete all the other spells out of your spellbook, because who needs the other one? The only thing is the casting cost is going to be very high. So it might not be that great to make it overpowered. For shield, it works, because you can just rest and the shield's still there. This will run out, and then you'll have to cast it again, and you don't have enough mana. You're going to have to take potions or rest just to cast it again, which you might not be able to do. So, just curious what that was. So, Spellmaker? Make me a spell. You know what? Exit. An exit, because I got stuck here before. I want to save. Hold on one second. Timer is running, I believe. Yes. We're probably into the next. We're probably into episode 23 at this point. Anyway. Spellmaker! Effects. Cure. Okay, so here we have it. Disease. Poison. Paralyzation. That's basically a free action. Or curse. Cure curse. Cure disease. Chance to... Okay. You know, it's interesting, though. I wonder... I have cure... I have free action. Free action. A 40% chance plus 2% per one level. I don't know if that includes the first level, but it's a small amount anyway, so... Figured... 18... Okay, so it's not... It won't always work. Alright. But we'll keep that as is. It's been pretty okay. So I want to... Cure... Disease. Chance 1% plus, how about... 10% per one level. So it's basically 100% chance to cure a disease. at my level. Or close to it, anyway. I don't know. Yeah, I think this is... it depends. If the plus 10% includes level 1, or it starts taking place in level 2. But either way, it's either 101% chance to succeed, or it's 91% chance to succeed at my level 10. So that sounds reasonable to me, and the casting cost is only 25. So I will call it should I call it something? I'm going to call it cure, because I want to keep it in line with the other cures. Cure. I think I'll just call it cure disease. Wait a second. I kind of want to be creative with the names, but I can't think of anything. Cure disease. I think I'm just gonna call it cure disease. It only costs me 5 tan as well. So this will help against ghouls and whatever else would put disease on me. Cure disease, let me see. I mean, this is what I'm going to be using through the whole game. Once I get to level 11, it's going to be, yeah, guaranteed 100% chance to, cure it. Yeah. I could call it cure malady or cure sickness or something like that, but yeah, just cure disease. Cure disease. It's my custom spell. By spell. Inscribed in your spellbook. Alright, so now I have 2117. I'm gonna save again. Because that was pretty cool. I'm loving the Spellmaker. And then, I don't know what I'm looking at. Anything else? Because I have 2117 gold. So say you wanted to damage the health on something. Range. Okay. Between 1 and 1 points. But then you increase it. So this would damage a guaranteed 51, unless the spell would fizzle or something like that, I guess. A 51 points of health. Well, 50 plus one level. So 411 points of damage at my level. Casting cost is 76 though, so I would only be able to cast it twice and then I'd be out. Oh, it's a target. It's a touch attack. I need more mana first before I do something like that. Then we've got continuous damage, like a dot spell. Damage over time. Those are my cures. It's damage designate as non-target. Let's just see. Designate as non-target. May cast offensive spells, yes or no? Okay, which means enemies should ignore you. And you can either, yeah, cast offensive spells at them. And I guess they will continue to ignore you. Or no, when you cast an offensive spell and they attack you. Guessing that that's what that means. That's not... This is all in my future. This is how... The things in this game will come to fear me, indeed. Drain attribute. You could drain their strength, intelligence, willpower. Yeah, all their stats. Elemental resistance. Fire, cold, electricity, acid, or poison. Yeah, at one point I'm gonna just replace like all or most of the spells with just my ramped up spells. I might keep some of the default ones around in case I don't have a lot of mana at the time, because that's always going to be the resource that is tough. You can't increase things to like insane levels and then expect your mana not to drain out. So, fortify attribute. So say you could fortify your own intelligence. Say 10 rounds per level, so it would be either 99 or 100, or 91 or 100 points per level, depending. Rate of release. Hold up. Increase one. Oh, this is a hard amount. You can't do that per level. Rate, unless, I don't know what rate of release is. I guess it will increase, or it will decrease. I think that's what it is. It decreases a certain amount. So it starts decreasing, you don't just lose it, boom, like that. I'm not gonna mess with that yet. I'm gonna mess with something else, probably. Okay, so heal health. Range. Range. Oh, one, two. Okay, so this is the range. Okay, so this is the range for per one level. This is gonna start out with just heals you 1 point of per level, and then like here would be 100 points or close to it, 91 or 100. You can go all the way up if you wanted to. Release 40 points per one level. That's 400. The casting cost isn't bad either, but I don't have that many hit points. So if I'm looking at like a full heal at this point, my health is only 65. I think my heal spell does that already. Alright, 65. Spellbook. Light heal. One or two plus 4 points per level. So, I know it doesn't heal me completely. What does heal do? That's very variable. 1 to 15 points, but the casting cost is really low. 12. 1 to 15 points to health plus 1 to 5 points per one level. So that's really random. So it could be anywhere from just, I guess, 1 plus. I guess like 10 points? 10 points to 15, whatever, 5. That is 45. 45 to 60? Between 10 and 60 points, I guess, at my level? 10 and 60? But that would heal me maybe completely as well. Because, oh, how much do I have? 60. Oh, it would almost completely heal me. I'm gonna bother with that yet. Anything else with the Spellmaker? Transfers. Figured attribute? Okay. Transfer attribute, I guess, from enemy to you. Levitate. Light, lock, open, regenerate. That's pretty cool. You can add effects. So you can, like, do like a levitating, regenerating thing or whatever amount you want to do. Like what could be like a, you know, a getaway spell that casts Sanctuary, which I think designates you as a non-target. So, let's see. For example, I'm just learning this stuff as I'm showing you guys. Sanctuary. Sanctuary does what? 50% chance target is ignored, plus 2% per one levels. One round per one levels. You may not cast other spells. Well, you could combine it with like a full heal or something. So, in case you're really in trouble, not only are you fully healed, but the monster stops attacking you. It's an interesting idea. That's one idea of multiple effects that you can put into a spell. Spell absorption is what I'm interested in. But at this point, because then you absorb it and take the mana for yourself. So if you increase what's the chance per level? So I think what happened was you will... It's already too much. 2120. One round. Yeah, I think I'll wait on this until I have more money. Otherwise I'll be making a weaker one and then replacing it with something else. So this will give me either 100 or 91% chance at my level 10 to do it, and it would last 100 rounds. I'm assuming it starts at level 1 for this, if not 90 rounds. Pretty sweet. Then we can absorb spells. The casting cost is high as hell. So I'm going to wait on it. I am going to wait on it, and we'll come back. Well, or we'll be going to the Mage's Guild in some place in Skyrim to do this. So we got new spells. We have Kynareth's Shield, and we have Cure. I think if I hit C, Alt C, no. We have Cure Disease. So find an inn. Which is to the east, but we can't go through here. So we're gonna cast Kynareth's Shield. It's interesting, it's not alphabetized. Boom! Now I have no mana. Success. Now you can only tell you are shielded, but I'm shielded for a lot of points. Was it like 900 points or something like that? I forget. Hold up. But I went for a lower... At some point I'm going to have a higher shield. +75 points every one level. So if it does start at level 1, that's 751 points. that enemies will whack us, and our health will not start going down until the shield is gone, and it's going to start draining out. Look, I have 3 spell points left. It's going to start draining out our 65 health. I wish there was somewhere you could see how much you are shielded for. I don't think there is. So now, because we're so drained, I'm going to get a room. I'm assuming one day is fine to get all this mana back. I'll just accept. And then rest until fully healed. 8 hours have passed. Now I have my shield on. And I have all my mana. That's not the way out. Dark. Actually, we're supposed to be going to Skyrim. I'm going to be going to Whiterun, I guess. Good central area. I guarantee you, it's going to look nothing like the Whiterun you know from Skyrim. But that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.